गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू लीगल मैटर्स बाय साई बाबू शंकर. यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द जजमेंट व्हिच इज पॉपुलरली कॉल्ड एज स्किन टू स्किन जजमेंट इन ए पोक्सो एक्ट केस wherein the verdict of the Bombay High Court has been negated by the Supreme Court. Once again, Bombay High Court has quashed the appeal, set aside the appeal in a POCSO Act case. So this is another case. Here, the single judge, Anuja Prabhu Desai, she has quashed the conviction of 10 years in a POCSO case given by the trial court against the accused Lakshman Verma. We have to know the reasons for the quashment. I can say the reasons for setting aside or allowing the appeal are regarding a child witness. Before that, let us know the facts of the incident. It happened on 11th May 2017. The victim, girl, aged about 4 years. So, she was inappropriately touched by the accused Lakshman Verma, who is working as a carpenter mestri in the neighboring house, by taking her onto his lap and touched her inappropriately. Whatever it is, according to the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act, that is popularly called as POCSO Act, it is definitely an offence, and he was charged. Ultimately, the Honorable Trial Court found him guilty under POCSO Act and awarded 10 years imprisonment for him. Now, he has filed an appeal before the High Court of Maharashtra. Now, the High Court of Maharashtra observed the tenor of the witness. You may be knowing, according to Section 118 of the Indian Evidence Act, which reads, who may testify in the court? Yes, anybody will testify in the court, provided the court is satisfied that they can answer. Particularly regarding the children, they can give the rational answers. That means they have got the maturity of understanding to answer. When the court is satisfied, then only they will allow the witness. Here, please remember, the witness is aged about just 4 years. So, her tenor disclosed that she did not have either cognitive skills to remember, to recollect and narrate the incident. So, she didn't have that cognitive skills. What is her maturity of understanding? So, to remember, to narrate and to recollect the entire incident, the tenor indicates that she has no such capacity. Secondly, she has no intellectual capacity also. She has no maturity of understanding the nature of questions. And it appears that the public prosecutor was allowed to ask the leading questions, which they are not supposed to do without permission of the court. Maybe a child witness, maybe an infant, maybe a dumb fellow, even they can give the evidence by signals also, by representations also. And maybe an insane person, when he is having the so-called lucid intervals, then only he can be called and he can depose. Otherwise, he is not expected to depose court of law. So therefore, anyway, the prosecution, normally the court will not allow the public prosecutor to give the leading questions in the chief examination. 145 Evidence Act, you may be knowing. Only at the time of cross-examination, any number of leading questions can be put. So ultimately, the girl is considered not to be a competent witness by the High Court. Finish. Entire case gone. So, the High Court came to the conclusion that the tenor of the witness indicated that she is not a competent witness to give evidence. So whatever she says in the court of law is not acceptable as evidence, and therefore the conviction of 10 years is set aside and the man Mr. Lakshman Verma is set free. So in this case you have to remember the competency of the child witness. That's why whenever a child is to be put before the witness box, the magistrate examines him. Maybe a male or a female. So the court has to be satisfied. Maybe the lower trial court might have been satisfied with the tenor or with the language or the way she disposed, but the record shows that she is not competent. She doesn't have the cognitive skills of remembrance, narrating and recollecting also. Then how could it? So we know that it is by tutoring by the PP, therefore only you could have gone for the so-called leading examination also. Anyway, the procedural irregularities made the case fail. So please read the judgment, Bombay High Court judgment if possible. So this is Lakshman Verma versus State of Maharashtra 2021. So, and definitely you will know the competency, discussion of competency of the witness. That's why time and again I have been telling you, your language and tenor should be appropriate. If not, nobody will be allow you to argue, even to appear as a witness in the court. Thank you very much.